This tutorial compares a Java and a native implementation of an object-oriented design where dynamic dispatching is used. Here's a diagram of the class hierarchy that the main program interacts with. The class diagram was generated from the Ada source, but the equivalent program in Java would produce the same result. Note that the root of the hierarchy is an interface, not a class. The responsibility of circle, rectangle, and triangle is to implement the interface specification. Hence, inheritance plays no role between the root and the first layer of classes. Where inheritance does occur, however, is between rectangle and square, where the method draw is overridden. Let's take a look at the code segments where Java is on the left and Ada is on the right. In Java, an interface is identified by the keyword interface. It includes the specification of one or more methods. In Ada, the syntax is type shape is interface, followed by the specification of an abstract subprogram. In this example, a procedure is used, but it could also be a function if the interface protocol required that. The object associated with a method in Ada must be stated explicitly as the first entry in the parameter list. In Java, this object is passed implicitly and is named this. In Ada, we can assign any name we want. In Java, the code used to create rectangle is class rectangle implement shape, followed by the implementation of the draw method. In Ada, the syntax is type rectangle is new shape. Unfortunately, the same syntax is also used for inheritance, so we can't tell from the declaration if we are implementing an interface or extending a class without referring to the parent. In Ada, the private part of the package specification is an area used to hide information from the client regarding data members. As a general rule, any information the client needs to know is shown in the visible part of the package specification. Otherwise, it is hidden, either in the private part of the specification or in a separate package file. In Java, the code used to create square is class square extends rectangle. A conscious decision to override the draw method, as opposed to creating a new one, is communicated to the compiler using the override annotation, followed by the implementation of draw. In Ada, the syntax is type square is new rectangle. As mentioned previously, Ada does not provide a clause to distinguish between implements and extends the way Java does. Ada does provide, however, the keyword overriding to mitigate the problem of accidental inheritance. Unlike Java, Ada separates the interface from the implementation using two different file types called the package specification shown here and the package body. In the diagram, that's why we don't see an Ada implementation of draw in any of the specification. The physical separation of interface and implementation has many advantages, especially when programming in the large. In addition to code reuse, the object-oriented paradigm also simplifies design and maintenance by allowing components to interact at the interface level instead of at the class level, thereby reducing coupling. Illustrating the program mantra, program to interfaces, not classes, is a key point in this tutorial. To eliminate any doubt that dynamic dispatching is used to make the method calls, the algorithm uses two iteration steps. In step one, at runtime, we populate an array with shapes selected at random. In step two, we invoke the draw method on each object in the shape array. The same steps are performed in Java. Here's step one, where we fill up the array with several random shape references. And step two, send the draw message to the shape interface. In the function nextShape, we cast each instance of a given shape up to the class-wide type anyShape, which is rooted at the interface, thereby effectively encapsulating each instance inside a black box which has a single interface connector on the outside. As seen in step 2 in the main program, the client sends the draw message to the interface. The dispatching mechanism will automatically bind the method to the correct object based on embedded tag information and then invoke the method. To recap, here is a quick scan of the Java program and the output. So you can see with each run, draw is called on the various shapes at random. And likewise for the Ada application. Here's the output. Run once again. This concludes the tutorial on dynamic dispatching in Java and Ada.